virtue that every sensation man has been inspired to have. I cared about what he wanted, and I never judged him. Why? Because I never rejected him. In spite of all his imperfections, I'm a fan of man!
The jinn are known to physically manifest into our world as black dogs, black cats, black birds, and snakes. There are even instances where they were able to manifest into human form. However, their most immediate effect in our world is in the influencing of mankind through whispering into our subconscious, placing certain ideas and thoughts into our heads. One's temper, the consumption of intoxicants, and the commitment of adultery eventually make it easier for these jinn to possess the sinner. Such possession allows the jinn to have greater influence on the human, making the human a successful result. The jinn, and is only successful for the jinn if the human spirit has been continuously weakened through external exposure to a sinful lifestyle. There are ultimately two forms of possession, voluntary and involuntary possession. Involuntary possession occurs when a human soul has become tainted due to disbelief, continuous sinning, or staying in a state of impurity for prolonged periods of time. Voluntary possession, however, is another story. This type of possession occurs when the jinn is commissioned through magic to possess the individual. The individual takes part in certain satanic and black magic rituals to which the jinn is voluntarily invited to possess the human. These acts are conducted by humans who have been exposed to jinn communication in the past. This communication eventually leads to the agreement between man and jinn for voluntary possession. The man agrees to this because he knows that giving the jinn the pleasure of possession would in return allow the jinn to perform certain services for the man. These services are what eventually led most men to the top level of society in terms of wealth, fame, and political influence. And ultimately, these men will eventually be led astray, falling right into the hands of Satan.
shit with me. And he said, hey, Marno, you're alive. How nice to meet you. He says, let's have dinner tonight. I said to my boss, can I have evening off? So I got the evening off and I went out and had dinner. How would you like to talk to the spirit of your dead mother? And I was shocked. I was shocked. He said, you wouldn't be afraid of talking to the spirit of your dead mother, would you? Well, I said, I'll tell you what, I would have to give that some thought. That's something I never thought about before in my life.
Most of us probably haven't. A little afraid of something like that.
Well, he says, you know, it's written all over your face. You're afraid of going to a seance. But he says, I know you. You're going to come. And then he started telling me how brave I was when I was aboard ship, you know, different things. He says, you're not the same man. You're changed. You're chicken. That's all I needed to hear. I said, when do we go to a seance? So one Saturday evening, we were in the place. It was our first time. Very beautiful place. The medium was a lady. Him to appear, just want to talk to him, because he says, I don't trust you talking to my friend for me. So the medium says, let me inquire of the spirit. Yeah, the spirit will talk with you. And that big masculine voice was heard in the place. Thank you.